this was a big day for Lebanon because we've held elections for the first time after so long, almost nine years of no elections in Lebanon. So first, as Lebanese, we're very happy to see this elections taking place in Lebanon finally. Our role as Alpha was major in this elections day on two dimensions, internal and external. External, we provided connectivity to the foreign minister, the foreign affairs ministry, with all the embassies of Lebanon around the world. Because for the first time in diaspora and Lebanese living abroad were able to vote and for the first time in the history of Lebanon. So we provided this connectivity between the head office of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs here in Beirut to the major embassies around the world to see this process taking place live and to remotely monitor what's happening in those places. This was a success because this happened almost a week before the elections day in Lebanon. Second, on the internal side within Lebanon, we provided also the Ministry of Interior with connectivity with the 15 major election centers in Lebanon. So this also enabled them to have a real time of what's happening in the different regions, especially when it comes to counting the votes and reporting back the results of the elections. On top of that, also all the media and the reporters in Lebanon, they relied on our 4G network and connectivity to do their live streaming during the day and to report and to inform the public about what's happening in the various villages, even remote areas in Lebanon, etc. It was a major success for us because during this day, almost zero outage happened on the network. Our network was up and running 24/7. Our teams were on the ground monitoring proactively and trying to avoid any outage or problem that might affect the performance of the network, might affect the people from communicating between each other or reporting results to each other. It was a major success by all means. During this day, we saw a traffic increase of almost 40% on the voice side. As we all know, voice is declining on a daily basis. On this specific day, voice traffic has picked up again and increased by 40%. The data traffic stayed the same in terms of volume during the day, but was redistributed according to the regions. We saw people leaving major cities like Beirut and moving to the remote areas where they have to vote. So this data traffic followed the flow of people and the movement of people within the country. One major thing for us that this increase of traffic, increase of all stability on the data side, but people using their phone during the day has resulted in a positive revenues increase, which is something that we are happy with. So what simply we can say that as part of our strategy of being supportive to all the Lebanese initiatives and the national initiatives, Alpha was there during this historic day and milestone in Lebanon, and we were up to it in terms of performance, in terms of capability, in terms of readiness to really carry the traffic and to enable Lebanese to communicate between each other. This is something we are very proud of today. For the last six quarters, we have been scoring very positively in terms of ranking on the internet throughput, especially on 4G, as far as Alpha is concerned. We have two reports coming from two different entities, OpenSignal and Ookla, which runs a speed test application. On the OpenSignal side, we have moved from the fifth position in the region to the second position in the last two quarters among the Arab countries in the MENA area. And we are ranked number 30 out of 88 countries with a throughput of around 26 megabit per second, which is slightly less than the number one position in the MENA region. On the Ookla side, the monthly report they issued showed that Alpha and Lebanon are ranked number 3 in the region. So we are not that far, second in one report and third on the second on the other report. Again, out of 130 plus countries they are measuring, we are really scoring very high. So we are very proud. It shows that the effort we have been doing in the last couple of years, the investment we have been making in terms of introducing state-of-the-art technologies like 4G, LTE Advanced, and lately with the few tests we did on 5G, it shows that the effort we are doing and the investment we are making, it pays off at the end of the day by improving the ranking of Lebanon, by improving the experience of our customers, and by contributing positively to making our people happier and happier on a daily basis, because they all rely on our connectivity on our services, and their level of happiness and satisfaction is highly dependent on what we are capable of offering in terms of high-speed internet. Absolutely, you know, we're very proud to say that we have moved from a traditional mobile network operator to a few years ago to a digital service provider, and to lately what I label personally as an HP, a happiness provider, rather than really a telco provider. And there are many reasons for that. It has been proven scientifically and medically that the level of happiness or the level of stress is highly dependent on the level of service you're getting from your digital service provider, between brackets. So the better the services are, the more satisfied and happy you are as a customer, as an end user. So this correlation between happiness and service efficiency has led us and me personally to really label Alpha as a happiness provider, because we have to provide the services that people are expecting on a daily basis, and that would make them happy because they can achieve their objectives in terms of day-to-day business, communicating with each other, enabling their potential and skills. And adding on the happiness side, we also take a lot of actions and initiatives that make people happy at the end of the day, be it helping the different NGOs that we support on a regular basis, people that we call with iron will instead of the traditional disabled definition. So at Alpha, we really would like to change this disabled tag and to rename them people with iron will, because they have an iron will to really overcome their problems, their difficulties on a daily basis to be very productive in our society. So this is one of the aspects we're making people happy. We contribute a lot to various initiatives in Lebanon. Alpha is associated to almost each and every single activity in Lebanon or event that is taking place. And by event and activity, I mean positive activities that are happening in the country, be it festivals, be it events that are related to cinemas. We're very proud to be the main sponsor of the latest Nadim Lebaki movie that won the Special Jury Award at Cannes Festival. So these are kind of activities that we are really happy and satisfied to be associated with, that contribute directly or indirectly to the happiness of our people. Basically, we're focusing on everything like any other single operator or happiness provider to use this technology. We cannot, while really forecasting our 5G rollout that is going to happen next year, we cannot neglect or ignore the existing infrastructure and the kind of technologies we have. And that's why we started recently, 2018, a massive expansion plan on 3G and 4G plus LTE Advanced. So we're almost expanding our network by 50% by adding another 500 new sites to the network, which will enable us to really cover 100% of the territory and the Lebanese population, or the population living in Lebanon, on both technology, 3G and 4G. So this will give us more capacity, more reach to people, a better throughput, so hopefully we'll be able to overcome the second position in terms of ranking, and we'll move to the first one soon. So this is on the existing network modernization. On the future looking, we have demonstrated recently during the Telecom Review event or summit in Beirut, the first 5G ever data session in Lebanon, where we reached a speed of 25 gigabit per second. And this is really the plan that we have today for the next couple of months and next 1 year. We aim at introducing and rolling out commercially 5G as soon as it gets commercially available. By this I mean the moment the suppliers are capable of delivering new sites operations on 5G, we will be one of the first to really roll them out in Lebanon and to make our people benefit from this technology, because we believe that 5G is a big change, maker and a game changer in the future, on which depends a lot of our sustainability, if you want, as human being, because this will enable us to achieve high speeds from one side, but also high latency or low latency on the other side, which is up to 5 milliseconds in terms of latency. So this in turn will enable us to really have IoT spreading out and proliferating across the country and Lebanon and other places, on which we can build really to monitor our natural resources, our environment, all kind of environment related issues on which we depend as human beings. It goes again back to the happiness provider concept and strategy that we have adopted recently. We cannot claim that we are a happiness provider if we do not have the reach needed to for our people to really talk to us and interact with us. So we started expanding our alpha stores and distribution channels. We are uplifting our concept in terms of alpha stores, making it really a customer friendly, a mobile environment, whereby people, especially the youth, can come and enjoy a unique experience of really end-to-end interaction with the operator or happiness provider. Currently, we have around 10 alpha stores operational in the country. We're doubling this number by the end of this year to reach almost every single city of Lebanon. And we have a plan going beyond to double again this number in the next couple of years, because we want to be very close to our people and our customers. Proximity is very important for them to come to us and interact with us and to enjoy the level of service and the unique experience we're offering in these places. This is a state of the art. You can see one of them here in this place, in this office. And like this one, we'll have around 20 by end of this year. Let me just state that privacy and customer data is a prime thing for us, and it's really of top priority and critical in terms of how we handle and deal with this data. And we have seen examples just discussed with you of some people trying internally, probably by mistake, to interfere with privacy and customer data, and we have seen them fired the next day or the same day. So we don't really joke when it comes to customers' privacy and data. And we just signed a couple of weeks ago a 3 years plan on InfoSec, information security, that will enable us to have our own SOC security operations center, along with other activities that really are aimed at protecting privacy and increasing it from the level we have it today to a level whereby we feel comfortable going back at home every day that our data, our customers' data, is well preserved. People are satisfied and they feel secure and comfortable when it comes to really dealing with alpha and dealing their data with us. So this is very, very crucial to us. As I said, we've signed an agreement, a multi-million dollar agreement with the company to really improve our security measures and take it to the next level. It's true that OTT has eaten up revenue side for the last couple of years. However, people were forecasting that operators would eventually disappear. There will be only OTTs, which is not the case, and people are still relying heavily on us in terms of delivering the service, making the infrastructure available for the OTT to reach their end customers and targets. The revenue loss that we have seen in the last couple of years because of OTTs have been a little bit compensated by the data uptake, especially on the internet and all kind of data services. It is true that we didn't really reach the level whereby there is a balance out between what we have lost from one side and what we have gained from the data on the other side. But other initiatives like on the value-added services, all kind of services that we can really put in the market, are one way of compensating this revenue loss. 5G and IoT would be a major, in my opinion, a major game changer, as I said, in terms of revenue even acceleration. We forecast, as per the recent studies, that around 2.9% increase would be on the GDP for the next 15 years. And out of the 2.9%, 10% of it will come from 5G. Which is, in our case, as Lebanon, is around between $2 and $3 billion increase in GDP, thanks to the 5G and to the data, mainly in IoT. So this is one aspect of really balancing out and trying to have this equilibrium between what we lose from one side because of OTTs and what we might gain because of additional services and 5G IoT specifically. We are doing all what it takes to be ready, as I said, to embrace the 5G technology the moment it is available for us to deploy commercially. And for that, if you remember in 2016 when we announced our 4G plus expansion plan, we signed at the same time MOUs with our telco suppliers to make our infrastructure and networks and network ready to embrace 5G whenever it happens. And we proved it that this year with the 5G test that we did during Telecom Review Summit and subsequently here at our head office. We proved that this MOU that we signed 2 years ago proved to be the right thing to do because we made the first session on our network. And we are continuing, and we're not stopping here, we're continuing in terms of making the infrastructure ready with both suppliers to be, as I said, ready before or by end of year 2018 and hopefully by, let's say, maximum or latest mid of 2019, we'll see the first few sites of 5G deployed in Lebanon.